Hi, and welcome to our Optomechanical How-To. In this video, we want to discover how to drive our motorized stages with the PC. We have prepared several items and Axel will introduce them to you.
So at first we will have a quick overview. So we have a rotary stage and a linear stage. We will control this via the controller and then the computer. So this is a two-stage controller. So it means we will connect the rotary stage and we will connect the linear stage to this controller. Then we will power this controller with the power supply. And here is a RS232 cable to USB. So we will attach the controller with the computer so we can run the controller via the computer.
After connecting the controller with the power supply and the PC, it is important to check the presettings. A too high current may harm our motorized stages. And now Axel will show us the wiring of the controller.
At first, we are using here these power cords to power our controller. We put this just in the socket. Then we connect our computer. So we have here this RS232 connector. We just wire this here. And then we just plug in this USB slot. And then let's have a look on the real computer settings. So we already downloaded and installed the SG sample software on this computer. You can find the download link in our description below. So at first step, we have to choose the controller. So in our example, we're using this two-stage controller. It's the GSC-02. Just choose it. Then we are allowed to choose the stages we want to use. So in our example, it's a linear stage and a rotary stage. So at first, we are taking the linear stage. In our case, we are using the HPS 80-50X. So we click choose. And for the second stage, we go on second stage and we're using the SGSP-40 YAW. And just choose. Now to find the right COM port, we have to go to the Microsoft settings. So we go to the device manager, scrolling down to the ports, and we see COM port 4 is required for our connections. So we go on setting, checking the ports. So in this example, it's fine already. Just click set. And then we want to test if the connection is stable. So we click on test, on connect. And here we get the feedback, everything is okay. So we are ready to go. We check the pre-settings of the controller. So now we are okay to wire the stages. So please, Esmat, show us how to.
In the first step, we take the extension cable and connect it with the connector. On the back of the device, you can find the interfaces for the connection. As Axel has said in the pre-settings, the slot 1 applies to the linear stage. Same goes for the rotary stage. We connect the cable with the stage and with the second interface. And are now ready to work.
We successfully connected the linear and the rotary stage to the controller. Now we can control the stage via stage control. We have here two options. Axis 1 is for the linear stage, and we have here the current position, and here we can move the stage to a specified amount. Also, we have here the option to drive the stage manually. Also, the same is here for the rotary stage. We can here move to a certain amount or also drive the stage manually. So let's have a closer look how we can run our stages with an Excel file. So for this reason, I prepared already one. So we have here the different stages. So stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, stage 4, so on and so on. So for this example, we're using two stages. So at column A, we have here the linear stage, and column B, we have here the rotary stage. So the first step, the linear stage is moving five steps forward, and the rotary stage is moving 4,000 steps forward. On the next step, the linear stage is moving minus 2,500 steps, and then the rotary stage is moving minus 2,000 steps. So let's close this and open it here in the software. We go to references, open here the Excel file, I call this run, and then I just click start. So I hope this helps you to understand better how you can control the stages. Let's have a brief overview of our motorized stages. Depending on which position you're using for your optical setup, different linear, rotary and goniometer stages are necessary. Here in this sketch you will see all the stages we can offer you. So if you want to control the stage, you need of course a controller. So depending on which stage you're using and how many stages you're using, different controllers are required. So if you need help to select the right controller, just get in touch with us. So if you control the controller, there are different software and scripts available. So in this video, we were talking about the SG Commander and the SG Sample software. Also, there are LabVIEW libraries and different software scripts available. OptoSigma controllers are commanded by a string of ASCII-2 characters with delimiters via COM port. There's our operating systems, software or script able to send strings via COM port may be used. On request, there's Python, MATLAB scripts and GUIs, and C++ libraries available. So if you have further questions to our motorized stages, please look in our description of the video and get in touch with us. Thanks for watching this video.